Welcome to the 19th session of corporate communication. In this session, we are going to discuss about a very important concept that is known as Dagmar approach. Before discussing on Dagmar approach, we are going to talk about advertising or communication objectives. In the previous session also, we were trying to understand how to measure the effectiveness of advertising. And during that session we talked about that we can measure the effectiveness by comparing it with the goals. Now, what can be goals? What can be those goals? The goals can be related to sales, related to market share, that can be one. And also we understood that what are the challenges of those marketing or sales related goals, and also we understood what are the situations in which those sales can be used as an objective to measure the effectiveness. So let's understand this pyramid, hierarchy of effect pyramid. So, and say for example, out of 100 people who are your target audience, target market, you are able to create awareness among 90. So 90% will be your awareness. Out of those 90, only 70 will understand what you are talking about, understand what your product is, understand what kind of solution, what kind of benefit your product is going to offer. So gradually, this percentage is going to is shrinking. So 100 people were there in the beginning as target. So only we become able to create awareness among 90. Now only 70 are able to comprehend, and out of 70%, only 40% are showing some kind of liking for our product, favorable attitude towards the product. So awareness and comprehension was part of cognitive process, and this liking and preference is part of this affective process. So 40% are showing positive favorable attitude, liking for a product, for a service, for a brand. And further, when preference comes into picture, only 25% are showing some kind of preference. So only 25% have analyzed your product, the computer's product, and showed some kind of preference. And even after 25% are showing preference, only 20% are going to try your product. After this trial, only it can be 5%, it can be 7%, it can be 10%, so it will definitely is going to be lesser than the trial percentage who are going to buy your product regularly. So this is known as hierarchy of effect pyramid. What can be our communication objectives? So say for example, our first communication objective is to create brand awareness among 90% of the target audience by December 2020. Or now if you say by December 21. So to create brand awareness, so that is my objective. I am creating brand awareness among 90% of the target audience by December of 2021. Now, what can be the second objective? Because we know this, just we have seen the image of the hierarchy, effect of hierarchy pyramid. So now my second objective is to create understanding of key brand benefits among the 70% of the target audience by December 2021. This can be another objective. Similarly, I can write down my third objective as creating positive feeling about the brand among 40% of among 40% and preference among 25% of the target audience by January 21 or something. Similarly, our fourth objective can be to obtain trial among 20% of the target audience by January 21 or something. Fifth objective can be to develop and maintain regular use among 5% of the target audience. Now let's discuss about the Dagmar approach. Dagmar stands for defining advertising goal for measured advertising result.
Defining advertising goals. So, advertising results. So, this is a very scientific process which talks about how we can measure the effectiveness of our advertisement. So, we set communication objectives. And these communication objectives are compared with the results, and which is going to define the effectiveness of our advertising. So this was Russell Cole has proposed this model. So Cole's rationale for communication based objective was as follows. Why he has given this kind of concept? Because since long, people have blamed the advertisers, the marketers, of spending organization's resources mindlessly without any result. So according to Cole, advertising's job purely and simply is to communicate to a defined audience information and frame of mind that stimulate action. Advertising succeeds or fails depending on how well it communicates the desired information and attitude to the right people at the right time at the right. So just pay attention to the words which are shown plus. So what is the advertising's job? To communicate to whom? To a defined audience. What information and frame of mind that stimulate action? So whether it sucks
succeeds or fails, its success and or failure depends on how well the advertisement is successfully communicating the desired information and attitude to the right people at the right time and at the right cost. So this is Cole's point of view. So already we have discussed this. What is the advertising's job? To communicate whom to a defined audience, what information and frame of mind, and for what purpose? To stimulate action. So to understand the Dagmar's approach, an advertising goal involves a specific and measurable communication task. Cole proposed that the communications task be based on hierarchical model of the communications process with four stages, which is known as ACCA. The full form of ACCA is awareness, comprehension, conviction, and action. So the goal of communication is to generate awareness about the brand, about the product. Second, to increase consumers' comprehension about the product and its benefit. Third, to convince consumers that the product offering is of use to them. So some kind of conviction to be built. And finally, to persuade the consumer to take action and purchase the product. So Cole has developed a checklist of 52 specific advertising tasks to establish objectives, few of which are mentioned in the following slides. So out of we are not going to discuss all the 52, just few which are very important, like create awareness about the product and its existence, create favorable emotional disposition towards the product. Favorable emotional disposition means liking, you can say. So until and unless you have a liking for a particular product, particular brand, you are not going to buy. So our mind is predisposed, means conditioned, a kind of preconditioning happens before taking any action. So you start liking about a product, then you buy. So this is disposition, emotional disposition. So you like it. Then impart information regarding benefits and distinctive features of the product. Then combat and offset competitive claim. Then correct false impressions, wrong information, and other hindrances to sale. Another objective can be aid sales force with sales promotion and selling activities and boost their morale. Establish brand recognition and acceptance. So these are the few objectives out of the total 52. So what are the features of good advertising objectives according to this Dagmar approach? So according to Dagmar approach, our objective must be concrete, measurable task. So concrete, measurable task of the objective. So out of the objective, we have to break it into measurable tasks. then we have to understand the target audience, then we have to set a benchmark or degree of change which we are expecting. And fourth one is the time period over which we want to achieve this objective. So first stage is this concrete and measurable task. The communication task specified in the objective should be a precise statement of what appeal or message the advertiser wanted to communicate to the target audience. So that should be a precise statement. The objective should be specific and clear enough to guide the creative specialist to develop the advertising message. And then unless the creative people understand what the marketer want, they will not be able to develop. So according to Dagmar, the objective must be measurable, quantifiable. There must be a way to determine whether the intended message has been communicated properly. Then target audience. The primary target audience for a company's product or service should be described precisely. It may be based on descriptive variables such as geography, demographics, and psychographics, on which advertising media selection decisions are based, as well as on behavioral variables such as user's rate or benefit sought. Third is the benchmark and degree of change which are sought. To set objectives, one must know the target audience's present status regarding variables such as awareness, knowledge, image, attitude, and intentions, and then determine the degree to which consumers must be changed by the advertising campaign. So the present status means how many people are aware at this point of time. And say, for example, from some research we have come to know that only 10% of people are aware about the brand right now. Then what is the degree of change which we are seeking? So we want to enhance the awareness level from 10% to 20% within 3 months. So that can be a degree of change which we are looking for. Then a specified time period. So for realizing that change, for bringing out such change from the present to the expected level, we have to fix a specific time. A final consideration in setting advertising objective is specifying the time period, within what period we want to achieve this. So my present awareness level is 10%, and within 3% by March 31st 2021 we want our awareness level to be at 20%. So what we want to achieve is clear, and at what time we want to achieve this must be clear. Most ad campaigns specify time periods from a few months to a year, depending on the situation facing the advertiser and the type of response being sought. So let's understand through an example. A company selling study materials of brand X for the preparation of CAT 21 sets the following advertising objective. So objective goes like this: to increase among 50,000 students in Patna who are preparing for CAT 21 the ability to identify brand X as one of the best study materials and persuade them that this will help them to get a score in CAT 21 from the present 5% to 25% in next 6 months. I understand you have not understood. Fine. Let's break it into different components. So target audience, 50,000 students in Patna who are preparing for CAT 21. So this is from that statement, the target audience is clear. Then my objective, what I want? I want that students must be able to identify the brand, ability to identify brand X as one of the best study material. So what I want that people and these 50,000 students of Patna must identify this brand X as one of the best study materials and persuade that it will help them to get good percentile in CAT 21. So my objective here is number one, to create an identity as the best study material, one of the best study material provider. And also it should help, it should convince, it should persuade them that this study material is going to help these students to get good percentile in 21, in CAT 21. So what is the desired change? I have stated from present 5%, because only 5% of the total population, 50,000 students, are aware about my brand X. Now, which I want to be enhanced to 25% from this present 5%. And the time given for this is stated as 6 months. Thank you.